Holy shit. I literally just finished recording a video about Nintendo Switch hacking, and the biggest development in the scene happened minutes ago. Kernel access has just been achieved by the Switch hacking team. I don't know these guys specifically. I know some of them, but not these guys. Look, take a look at this. Right there, as you can see, we got the kernel already. It's been 4 months since this console has been released, and today it was cracked in half. I'm literally editing my video to do my Switch, talking about the Switch hacking stuff right now. And then this just happens out of nowhere. The kernel has been achieved, my boy. I've told you about it before. Having access to the kernel is basically like, that's it, game over. That's like ARM9 loader hacks in the 3DS. And for the Switch to now be in that state, the future of Switch hacking is bright as hell right now. This is one hell of a time to be alive. Record time for a Nintendo console to be cracked like that. Insane! Anyways, back to the video. Remember, the following video you're about to see was like maybe a few hours ago before Switch kernel access was discovered. So, enjoy. I haven't said much about it, but the Switch hacking scene has been on fire lately. Some people out there have the ability to import models into Switch games like ARMS and Splatoon. I'm not claiming that I'm super expert at this, but I am in communication with a couple of people who are heavy duty in the Switch hacking scene. They know their thing when it comes to being in the ring with Nintendo on some legal terms, on some intellectual property terms, and they kind of try to give me a little bit of a breakdown as to what this is. I'll try to explain it in layman terms as best as possible. Yes, there are some very gaping holes in the Switch's infrastructure that people have been taking advantage of down low. The reason why none of this stuff is being talked about or a public release is being done like with Ninjax back in the day is because they don't want Nintendo to patch up these openings before they have a chance to exploit them. Once Nintendo actually does catch on to where their system is vulnerable, they'll patch it and then those guys will release the exploits that they had afterwards. I didn't get the logic at first either, but it's because if you're on that firmware still and the vulnerability is patched afterwards, then if you're still in that firmware, you can take advantage of it and they can move on to the next vulnerability. But in terms of what is able to be done right now, they are able to actually get contents from Nintendo's own servers, download them, and decrypt them, which I know is a process that initially was holding back the progression of the hacking scene because decrypting the files could take a lot of work. They didn't really have the way to do it. And at first, the people that I was in communication with didn't really know if they would be able to decrypt it within a good time period or not, but apparently they were, and now they have access to everything. So what that basically means is that everything about the Nintendo Switch right now, even though they don't have kernel access yet, is able to be hacked, downloaded, messed with, tinkered with, and that is the reason why model swaps are currently available. But that's only one aspect of the Switch hacking scene. Another place that they saw some unusual activity, maybe just for Nintendo standards, is that they actually have a lot of monitoring tools to tell Nintendo specific information about your play sessions with the Nintendo Switch. From what he tried to explain to me, Nintendo is now documenting how long you're playing a title and sending that to their servers. They're telling them what games you're playing, certain things that you download. I mean, and it doesn't really seem like that's information too crazy. I mean, they're monitoring your activity, but that's nothing in the sense of like my privacy is being infringed upon or like, you know, invaded. Rather, that's information that I think is very valuable for Nintendo to have, and it's actually kind of refreshing to see that finally they have a way to monitor that stuff. I asked the guy if they had similar systems to that on the Wii U or other Nintendo hardware, and he said not to his knowledge. So know that Nintendo is now keeping track of your play sessions, how long they are, and I mean, hopefully they can use that information to make the system even better. And if you remember when we previously talked about it, having kernel access to a system basically means that you can do anything with it. You can make adjustments to the firmware, you can make adjustments to programs as free as you want without any restrictions or limitations. We haven't reached that point just yet, but we are so far along now when it comes to this manipulation of the file systems. They have access to them. I had asked the person I'm in communication with, hey, is this like a record time period for how fast this thing went down? Because it's only like, what, 4 months after the console's release? This has to be record-breaking time. As far as they know, apparently the Wii U, to get the same amount of progress in the hacking scene as the Switch has now, took a year. This is the fastest hacking of a Nintendo console in history. or unless the 3DS beat that record. But from him saying, but if we're just comparing it to consoles, the Wii U took way longer. So that just goes to show you that the Switch is probably going to have a lot of interesting, exciting opportunities for homebrew applications, not piracy, because I don't condone that, but other useful things and features that we can use functionality wise. Even though the system's hardware in terms of like pushing raw gaming power is somewhat questionable, I know for a fact that things like Virtual Console and importing other cool games on there is going to be a interesting prospect for the Switch. So where does this leave us now as general consumers with Switch hacking? We still don't have a public release because the people who have access to the Switch's internal memory and access to decrypt the files that they're downloading, they don't want to release the stuff just yet. I kind of compared it to just being a circle jerk of niggas who feel good about the fact that they have that kind of information, have that kind of access, and they're just holding on to it. But of course, they're waiting for Nintendo to patch it if they do discover the vulnerability. But we're still nowhere near like a public release. I mean, for the information to kind of be compressed and given to us in a consumer bite package, we would have to like probably wait maybe another like 4 to 5 months. But the fact that they have access to these tools right now is major. And even though we won't be able to do anything with it yet, just know that yes, things are moving forward. I also am curious about them having a way to potentially transfer save data from Switch to Switch, do backups in a more efficient manner. I mean, Nintendo does have these features coming out as well, but it doesn't really seem like that's going to be happening too fast. But then again, we don't know the time frames personally. If the hackers are able to do it faster, then you know what? I'll take it. One way or another, we'll keep our eyes on the hacking scene as it progresses. And if there's any other major updates or stuff that I think is interesting to talk about that I know you guys will be excited to see, you definitely can guarantee, bet your black ass, that I'm going to be on top of it. Bet my black ass, rather. I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Take care of yourselves. And of course, as usual, please have yourself a damn good one.